members of America's left are continuing their ongoing assault on the women associated with the Trump administration. The Washington Post's Michelle Rubin actually encouraged the left to continue harassing Sarah Sanders. Watch this.
We're not going to let these people go through life unscathed. Sarah Huckabee has no right to live a life of no fuss, no muss, after lying to the press, after inciting against the press. These people should be made uncomfortable, and I think that's a life sentence, frankly.
That's not all. Over the weekend, Michelle Wolf, best known for botching the White House Correspondents' Dinner with vitriolic attacks against Sarah Sanders, called the Ivanka Trump a selection of names, some of which are too graphic to air. But here's an example.
Is your nickname Herpes because you're not necessarily the most dangerous person in the administration, but you're very unpleasant, totally incurable, and you always show up when we're about to get Remember, discourse is a path to change, and Ivanka is the prettiest tumor in a swiftly moving cancer.
And joining me now with reaction is the host of Michelle Malkin Investigates on CRTV, syndicated columnist Michelle Malkin, and Florida Attorney General Pam Bondi. And I should note that it's Jennifer Rubin with the with Washington Post. All right, now, you know, I thought it was over. I really did. After my show on Saturday night, I said, you know what, and they probably just vented. But over the weekend, it got even worse. We're not going to let this one go unscathed. It needs to be a life sentence. And, of course, Pam, we know what happened to you. And, Michelle, both of you have been harassed. And now it's continuing. Pam, what's your take on this?
Well, my take on this is Michelle Wolf does not know Ivanka. I do. She is a loving wife, a remarkable mother. She is a great human being, and she's not going to break down. They couldn't get to the president, so they think they can get to people around him. Ivanka's not going to be broken down by this, but none of us are going to be bullied. But everyone who's saying these things, they need to realize, and they know this, Janine, just like you, Michelle, and I know this, there are people out there who exist who will be emboldened by this to do harm to someone. Something bad is going to happen, and everyone just needs to say, stop it, unequivocally, stop.
You know,
stop,
Michelle,
doing this now.
I had someone on my show, and he said, well, you know, it's on both sides. And I said to him, I said, do me a favor. Tell me where conservative women have taken on a Democrat female, whether she's elected or not elected, or spokesperson. Give me one example. Oh, it's the same on both sides. I don't know that to be the case. Do you?
It's not the case, and I've documented the war on conservative women for upwards of 20 years now. It is not, and never has been, Judge Jeanine, the case that conservative women who very vigorously oppose ideas on the other side go and target the children of people with which we disagree. We're not the ones that have forced the other side to have to hire private security guards to speak on college campuses, as I have over the years, and so many other female conservatives who are outspoken. What this is really about is the fact that the C word, the real offensive C word to the left, is conservative. This is about criminalizing and ostracizing female conservatives for being female and conservative. The left considers it an ideological felony to be a woman and a conservative. And even more than that, they think it's a capital offense to be a minority and a female and a conservative. And so that's what this is really about.
Pam, you know, what she says is so true. I mean, you were in the movie theater, you know, and I've gone to universities. I've had to have security. I mean, I've had it most of my life anyway. But, you know, going forward, it doesn't sound like they're doing anything to tamp it down. What should Republican conservative women do?
Well, first of all, you won't be bullied. Michelle won't be bullied. Sarah won't be bullied. Ivanka won't be bullied. I won't be bullied. But the other side has got to stop it. You've got to just unequivocally, all of our Democrat friends out there who we all know need to come out and say, stop it. Stop it. This isn't right. Someone is going to get hurt. And I've told you there was a state rep with her children, children being screamed at and harassed by the same people that came after me. So this just, women attacking women, gotta stop.
Well, you know, Michelle, she's right, but this isn't about civility anymore. If we say, stop it, don't do this, is that gonna stop them? No. So should charges
be filed?
When
yes, I think that there needs, yes, I think. think there needs to be legal consequences for people who are inciting violence. And the best thing that we can do is what we're doing. Sunlight is the best disinfectant. Turn the tables and put the mirror on people who are nothing of the type of self-appointed civility police that they talk about. In fact, these are the worst, most vile offenders against civility. And when you have people who think that it is part of proper public discourse to call for giving a quote-unquote life sentence, as this loon Jennifer Rubin has done against Sarah Sanders, simply for doing her job, that has crossed the line. It is beyond the pale. And the Washington Post and the owners of the Post should be shamed that this woman is employed by them as a so-called conservative columnist. That's the biggest joke.
And you know what, Pam Bondi, you're the attorney general. You're a very powerful woman in a state with your own security detail and your own guards. And yet they have no fear going in your face, within an inch of your face.
They don't, and that's where people need to realize someone is going to get hurt. And like Michelle said, I mean, the ultimate bullying, this Michelle Wolf woman saying, go after their deepest insecurities, really, to say that? It's horrible. But see, we're not going to get in the gutter with them. That's the difference. And Democrats, there are plenty of Democrats out there who do not agree with what's happening, and they just need to unequivocally say, stop. Stop this. Do not do this. Someone is going to be harmed.
All right. So good to have you both on tonight. Thanks so much. And still to come, President Trump keeps racking up accomplishments, and members of the mainstream media are even finding it hard to ignore them. That and more after the break.